Anybody seeing the rocket?
I'm looking.
Where? Anybody got the rocket?
You seen anything?
Did anybody ever see the chute pop?
I didn't hear it pop. I didn't see anything.
It's gone.
If it was lawn darted, we'd have probably heard that thing thud big time.
Yeah.
During our last and most ambitious experiment of the year, one of the strangest things we've ever witnessed on Skinwalker Ranch just occurred. A high-powered rocket capable of reaching a speed of 800 miles per hour and an altitude of 10,000 feet seems to have just vanished after we launched it up through the anomalous zone above the triangle.
Who knows what happened to that rocket?
Who knows where it went? I mean, it went out of sight and I never heard it come down.
Nope.
I don't know what happened to it.
What's most incredible about this is that 10,000 feet above the triangle is right where a radar balloon scan that we conducted earlier this year detected a shift in time of a quarter of a second.
Go for launch.
Off it goes.
We lost a quarter second of time.
Really? For data like this, a quarter of a second is huge.
And believe it or not, that actually offers evidence of what many scientists, including Albert Einstein, have believed would be a side effect of a nearby traversable wormhole.
And we've probably got about a terabyte of data to look through. That's not an exaggeration.
Eric, I can't wait for us to download that and play back through it frame by frame.
Oh, yeah. I'm anxious to go collect those trackers, retrieve those from the drones, and then I'm ready to break it down. Go take a look at the data.
Yeah, I think so. So I think it's time for us to pack it up.
Yeah, I think it's been a great night.
I'm in.
All right. Great work, everybody.
Thank you very much.
After Eric spent several days reviewing the massive amounts of data we collected during our final experiment, Brandon Fugel asked the team to meet at his offices in Salt Lake City for a briefing and to discuss everything else we documented this year.
It's great to be back with everyone. Thank you for coming together. I appreciate Governor Herbert joining us for this historic briefing.
We were joined not only by former Governor of Utah, Gary Herbert, but also Jim Royston, the CEO of Omnitech and former executive director of the International Space Station Laboratory, as well as Jay Stratton, who worked with Robert Bigelow to investigate the ranch in the early 2000s and was a career defense intelligence senior leader who was my boss when I took part in the federal government's UAP task force between 2019 and 2022.
I think it's important that we dive right into the material and the findings from the recent months of investigation and research, which has been more groundbreaking and historic than ever before.
Now, during this drone experiment, we were collecting thermal imaging.
Yeah.
We had the FLIR camera set up looking at a portion of the mesa and at a swath of the sky. And there are, in fact, some things that show up in that footage that really catch my attention. So here we see the rockets have launched. This was a simultaneous launch of a pair of rockets.
Yeah, that's awesome.
So besides the rocket launch itself, you may notice that there are things showing up in the thermal that we did not see with our eyes. So I'd like to show you this in a different representation. Here we have a relief. It gives it a three-dimensional quality. And some of the features show up a little more clearly when we look at them this way.
Whoa.
Wow, look at that. Oh yeah, you clearly see the object.
You seeing it move across?
I see it.
I mean, you see it when it appears.
So I'm going to take us back just a little in the timeline.
That object is clearly there, but it didn't fly in. It didn't come up over the horizon. It just appeared in that spot. How did it get there?
Explain how it would appear out of thin air.
We've seen a lot of UAPs in the skies above Skinwalker Ranch. And seeing this one appear out of nowhere on the same night where a rocket may have disappeared around 10,000 feet above the triangle just makes me wonder if they could be related.
Wait till you see the next thing I've got for you.
Oh, there's more.
Oh, yeah. In this case, I have what I classify as ensembles of targets moving as if in formation. I want you to focus on this part of the screen here.
Whoa. Oh my God.
You see what's happening? Now look what happens.
Oh my gosh. It's slowed down and changing position. That's huge.
What was that? Now there's like four or five of them.
Did you see that? I thought it was one object. They broke apart.
Yeah, there's multiple of them.
I gotta see that again.
You got it.
So there they come up from the bottom right of the screen. You see them right there, and then as they move in.
You say they, it looks like one object to me.
Wait till you see it.
Yeah, that's one. That is one object right there.
That's one object.
And then right here, watch. Right. There. Then it split right there.
Has it split or is it just morphed?
I can dive in. So here they are. You can see that there are discrete objects in this set.
Yeah.
Like the cell dividing.
And this is absolutely fascinating.
When we first saw this UAP split into smaller ones during our experiment last week, it was certainly baffling. But when Eric refined the footage and zoomed in, so much more detail was revealed, and it was absolutely shocking.
So I'm going to remove that filter. Here is our raw data, Brandon.
It's on the thermal, though.
It's thermal.
Yeah.
No, it's a fleet.
Flying formation.
They are flying formation.
So what you're looking at is something that is warmer than the ambient. The first thing I would think is I'm looking at a flock of birds.
Geese is what I would think. They're flying in a V or something.
Yeah. But this is, in fact, in the middle of the night.
Regardless of night, it doesn't follow bird patterns. Where they're so tight, they're in one ball, and then they break off.
Think about it. Yeah, if they are formation flying, something is communicating their formation with each other, or each one of them is making individual measurements quickly so that they don't fly into each other. If they're being controlled from somewhere, then there's a signal that would be being broadcast between them, updating their information. Could these things have been formation flying through remote or somehow in communication with each other?
This is from later during the course of this exercise. You're looking at the raw thermographic footage.
Oh, and it just appeared.
It didn't come up over the horizon. They were just there.
What's the number count? Four or five?
I think five or six. Five. Oh, look, more of them split off.
Yeah.
And how fast are they going is the question.
The other thing that I find kind of peculiar about this is the uniformity of this motion. It's so smooth. You know, normally when I see, at least in the near field, when I see birds flying through my field of view, I see very erratic type of movement. You know, I see the movement of the wings, and I also see direction changes. This is eerily uniform, you know, as it moves through our field of view.
The interesting thing to me is that you've got it at two different times, looking in the same field of view, same direction. You didn't change the camera's viewpoint, which suggests it being a common spot for whatever this is.
We've heard that the ranch is an intelligent entity, that it's home to a secret underground base, and that it might even be a gateway to other dimensions. Well, we've documented scientific evidence that supports each one of these legends. All I know is that in order to find the truth, we have a lot more work to do.